Raman spectroscopy measures the vibrational patterns of molecules, which are unique for a specific compound, like a fingerprint. In library matching, one compares this measured Raman fingerprint for an unknown compound to many different Raman fingerprints for known compounds. If the fingerprints agree, the unknown compound has just been identified using its Raman spectrum. In this video, I will show you how to use library matching in the ENLIGHTEN software. So, let's get started. I am using ENLIGHTEN here with a 785 Raman system that covers the fingerprint region and has a built-in laser. In the Raman section of the software, I record the dark signal first, which is the detector offset that will be subtracted from the spectrum. Next, I switch to the Raman setup, scroll all the way down to the bottom, and select the three corrections that are needed to perform this library matching. These three corrections are, first of all, limiting the spectrum to those pixels on the detector that are actually recording Raman emission. This is the so-called region of interest. Secondly, removing the spectrometer-specific spectral response curve with this intensity correction. And lastly, correcting for the more limited resolution of this compact spectrometer with this sharpen option. Finally, turning back to the capture page, I scroll down to find the baseline subtraction here on the right, which subtracts any fluorescence background from the spectrum. This is all the setup needed for library matching. Now I can insert my sample. This here is cyclohexane. And I turn on the laser. There it is. Beautiful. To identify the compound, all I need to do is to click on this fingerprint button. The button turns red, indicating that the spectrum has been submitted. The matching results are now shown in this region on the bottom left. Here's what we see. The match is cyclohexane, which is correct. The score is 97 out of 100. Everything above 95 is considered really good. And it took just 1 second to match this spectrum. And the process completed properly. Awesome. Let's try this again. Here we have acetone. As an example, I click the button and wait for my match. And there it is, acetone, a score of 99. Awesome. Here's ethanol. I process the spectrum, click the button to ID. And what do we find for ethanol? As what do we get from ethanol? Perfect. Score of 97, also really good. Next, we try acetaminophen or Tylenol or paracetamol, depending on where you are. I click the button to identify it. And the library said the match is for acetaminophenol. That is actually the same compound. The library just called it something differently. And last, 2-aminobutane. Why 2-aminobutane? Well, the library is large, but not every compound is in it. And this is one of them. And if I try to match it, what do I find? The response we get is no match, which is actually correct. There is no match in the library. This is a good response. Perfect. This, in a nutshell, is how to do library matching in ENLIGHTEN. It really is pretty easy to use. Library matching uses the strength of Raman spectroscopy, recording a unique spectrum in seconds without any sample prep. This is a powerful addition to ENLIGHTEN that allows you to identify unknown samples or verify known samples against an extensive Raman library. So go ahead, give it a try. This library matching is so easy to do and actually a lot of fun to use. I'm sure you'll like it too. Thanks for watching. See you next time.